Aalto University Metsähovi Radio Observatory is the only radio astronomical observatory in Finland and one of the very few in Europe.
The observatory has worked here in Kirkkonummi since 1974. Our main instrument is the 14-meter radio telescope that's inside a protective radome that protects it from the heat radiation from the sun. So we can actually turn the radio telescope towards the sun, something that you can never do with a normal telescope. To observe it with radio frequencies or radio waves enables us to see certain activity in the sun, even though with our normal eyes, sun doesn't seem to be doing anything.
While we do try to cover individual events such as violent solar flares or coronal mass ejections that can literally destroy satellites or cause electric blackouts on Earth, our main goal is to cover the behavior of the sun on timescales of several decades.
And from our observations, we can, for example, predict aurora days before they actually happen. We also study supermassive black holes inside active galaxies.
Our long-term monitoring helps other researchers and other observatories put their data and observations into a longer or bigger context. So, for example, when we were participating in the Planck satellite project, it monitored a lot of different active galaxies or quasars. One really interesting source was undergoing the most violent flare ever recorded in its history. The black hole in the center of the galaxy had probably eaten a star or something like that. And without our data and long-term context, the researchers would have probably been interpreting those results as completely usual.
And we also participate in international very long baseline interferometric observations where we combine radio telescopes around the world to operate as one huge, usually a planet-sized radio telescope.
The telescope collects the radio waves, focuses them into something called a receiver, where these radio waves are amplified, and for that reason the receiver has to be very sensitive, it has to be cooled because also warm objects radiate and can create noise in the system. That's why the receiver is cooled to the temperatures close to the absolute zero.
The whole Metsähovi Observatory area is a radio quiet zone, meaning that we cannot use, for example, cell phones, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, or anything that emits radio waves. The objects that we study are extremely distant and therefore also extremely faint. Single cell phone near the telescope would completely overpower any sources that we would otherwise observe. Previously, we used to have snakes coming into the equipment. On a typical summer day, we could have easily three separate snakes in the same computer or receiver equipment. The snakes were not venomous, so they were the constrictor type and only about this long, only dangerous if you are a mouse. But nevertheless, we didn't want snake poo in the equipment. And also, it's not really nice to be the engineer who has to go and put their hands into the cables, and then suddenly the cables come alive and start hissing. So fortunately, after the recent renovation, the snakes have stayed outside.